Hi, and welcome to Black Country Blitz PC Gaming. And you join me here in Assetto Corsa Competizione. Now, I've already posted a replay of a previous hot stint that I did, which was the Mercedes AMG 2020 at Monza. So I thought, you know what, let's get on camera, let's pop the McLaren Fanatec GT3 wheel on, and let's do the McLaren 720S GT3 at Silverstone. Now, this is a 30-minute hot stint. It has been raining, or the track is wet. So, without further ado, let's get it loaded and let's get it on.
Right, this session is about consistency. Try to be fast, but don't push it over the limit.
Now that's easier said than done. Especially when you hear that brilliant. Right, we'll give it a good go. So we get track IR sorted. That's what I'm using for head tracking this morning. There's little pools of water on the track. So let's get these tyres warmed up. Gotta start really gearing it some, as they say.
Green light, green light. Go, go, go.
Now I enjoy doing these specials. This one, it learns you to get used to the circuits. And two, to see how much I'm improving when it comes to driving. Now, I ain't long bought this Fanatec McLaren wheel, and the reason behind it is that I've got an F1 wheel, but there ain't enough buttons to map all the buttons and everything in this game. So, today a really dear wheel from Fanatec. I treated myself to one, you know, to work all the time for nothing. You could treat yourself once in a while to something, but that's what I did. So as I'm trying to now learn how to tweak these cars and understand what I'm doing, it's no good doing that if you ain't got the wheel rim. I ain't gonna go and buy every wheel rim for every certain car, because most of the time you can map the buttons to most of the cars with this one. Otherwise we're spending a lot of money on wheels. But I can understand why people do it by getting the appropriate wheel, the appropriate car, easily. It is a fantastic wheel to use. As I said, I was using more F1 eSports, which I think Fanatec have discontinued now. So, and at the time when I purchased my Fanatec gear, I hadn't got the money for one of their Oya F1 wheels. So to me, it does exactly what I need for F1 racing. Now, what I do like about this McLaren wheel is how quick it is to take off. As you all know, Fanatec wheels, you can just stop your game, quick release job, hop on another wheel and carry on gaming. Now, with this, all it is turning and like a big screw at the back and pulling off. Simple. Where the other two wheels I've got, the better quick release, but I'll put a pin in, stop breaking the pins within the wheelbase, or the pins which Fanatec use to make connections, as I broke the pins twice in one of my universal hub, and one of the pins got stuck in my wheelbase. So twice my stuff has had to go back to Germany. But I'm happy to say that Fanatec have got a fantastic customer service. And the last time that my wheel and my wheelbase had to go back, I got it back within 4 days, or five days, which is good going. So no problems from Fanatec whatsoever. But I wished this kind of quick release was on the other two as well. The only thing is, if I do ever upgrade to a direct drive, I'm looking at upgrading to a DD. I'm thinking about it big time. I'm seeing reviews on other people saying, especially this title, the set of course comes to China, you feel every bit of the circuits, or you know, the cars with a direct drive over a belt driven. So rather than waste money on rubbish, I may as well buy something that I'm going to get enjoyment out of. Just a little bit nervous getting one and going breaking my wrists. I've already hurt my shoulder with a belt driven, so again, I've learned not to turn your four speed back up to the maximum. There's no need. You know, it's nice, or it's like, you know, when you first get it, oh, I want to feel. You soon get fed up of driving with really high intense four speed back on in most of the sims. Now, like for instance here now, driving this, I've got it at 100% in the game and about 70 in the wheel, and it's so, you know, the tension or the resistance is enough for me. I can feel everything, I can feel the rumble strips. I do like to feel them. Again, I'm lucky that the cushion provides most of the feeling for me. You might be hearing that through the microphone. If you hear any popping, it's the transducers going stupid as I go over rumble strips or brake, as it covers your braking. When I accelerate, it makes noises. I also feel tire slip. Tire slip. Traction loss. I wouldn't be without more cushion. Now, I was going to get a butt kicker, but that would only rattle the whole race rig. Again, I could add one of them as well, but Fanatec pedals vibrate on the brakes, and they also vibrate on the accelerator pedal. So I think I've got enough shaking, but with the wheel, the pedals, the cushion, I don't need no more things that vibrate. I don't know if anybody else experiences it when you come off some of the titles. My hands tingle sometimes for a good 15 minutes, depending on how long I've been playing these sim titles. And I don't know if that's a bad thing or a good thing. I mean, it's a discomfort. It's just like, I wouldn't say pins and needles, but it's like you can feel There's some going on in your hands and your fingers. So. Anyway. We're nearly 10 minutes into this 30 minute stint. I thought it might have rained while I'm actually playing. Now, the last one was actually raining all the way through it. If you ain't checked it now, go and check out the replay from Monza. That was actually a good race, and I wished I'd have recorded it from this point of view. What I do like about these simulators is the track will dry up as the weather changes, or you know, I'm sure if I can get this down to about 1,300 by the time the half hour's up, I'll be happy with that if I can. Trying to nail these apexes as best as I can. This wheel compared to the F1 esports one, the actual material they use, I'm glad they never put it on this GT Star one, because this being rubber, your hands don't seem to sweat so much when playing. I don't wear gloves with it. Okay, this has got no internal motors that vibrate, but bother me, to be fair. Say it's shaking enough for what I need vibration wise, so that's what makes it different to the F1 with the little vibrating motors. How are we doing for laps?
Brother mate, this is me, your personal best.
Personal best again. So what we're doing, 1,493. Still got a long way to go to get that down to about 300. Are you going to do it? Messing up corners like that. Nearly 15 minutes left. We're nearly running out wide then. Managed to grab it back. Catches me out that corner. Not tonight, it don't, or this morning. I wandered down nearly. The adrenaline rush these drivers must get when them bombing round these circuits in these GT3s cars must be off the charts. I buzz myself just sat in a simulator, never mind. Being in the real thing, I mean, when you put a VR headset on, oh my days. As we all, anybody that's got a VR and plays these kind of games, it's just another world. And the way technology is going now for VR, you've seen what's coming out. 12K. I think it's 12K VR headset. Should I read it? Or Sony? 12K. Getting slower instead of faster. You can do for like maximum amount of speed down to like near enough, you know, say 160 mile an hour down to like 10 mile an hour in a fraction of a second in these cars. It's just like, whoa. Nearly lost it then, must admit. They all saying, how are you going to light? Felt it start to slide.
Well done, mate. That's the fastest lap.
That's what I like to hear. In these times. Yeah. Good quotes, I'm trying to concentrate, that's all. I am at the moment, to be fair. But some people might say, oh yeah, I done that race. Well, here I am in the flesh. Here hit me all, as they say. I should be a bed, but right, as I always say, I'll have plenty of time to sleep when I'm dead. I said, no work today, so. They all say, no work and no play. Well, I can play today. As long as my eyes can keep open. pumping caffeine into me, and I'll be fine. And wee breaks. Good job, the brain tells me that. I need to have a toilet break once in a while. Thinking of getting a bottle and a tube. I'd have to shift out the simulator then. You're joking, like. Oh, I love that bin. Look at that goop. Whee! Come on. Moving like this, if the car's going to go any faster. And I have got a set of, what they call them, got a harness. I think I ought to put myself in it. Seat belts. Very rarely use one this week, to be fair, though. I am there if I need them. Just stops you moving about when you're tightly strapped in. Don't need a motion rig, I make my own. Although, to be fair, track IR really helps. I mean, when I'm racing, there's nothing better than just having a look. A bit like VR, but not totally in the game. Oh, whoa. Are you talking? Good to talk though, eh? Turns that wheel all the way around. I'm still going to beat my lap time by the looks of it. It's all good.
Well done, mate. You're still fastest lap.
No time for errors. Famous bend I normally mess up on. Not tonight, morning. No, it's where am I coming from? Come on. Tell I'm going into it. The Was it that rumble strip a little bit too much then? But it did spun me. It hadn't. Felt the back wheels starting to go. I thought, here we go, I've lost the car. Well, we've got 6 minutes left. Oh, gone there, it took very long. That half hour's gone ever so quick. The last. How long? Oh well. Nearly lost it at the end. I got 4 minutes. Don't think I only hit 1,300, but I. Better than when I started. I think it was in 2000 and some odd. Watch that sausage curb. Sometimes I've gone over that, man, the car's gone everywhere. Again, same corner. Shit. Oh well. Take the grassroots. Right, we got one more chance to try and do this. Come on. Last lap. Yes, have it, that 1,300. Brilliant, just what I wanted.
Oh, come on. On my sausage cab now. So what I mean? I hate that sausage making this all over. Have it, folks. 30 minutes hot stint here at Silverstone. Right, let's have a look at what it's got to say. Whew, that was intense. Right then, where did I get? Does it give you anything? Ah, there we go. So my best time was 2 minutes 14. Is it? Yeah, 2 minutes 14 is my best time. And that was on the last lap. Anyway, hope you've enjoyed that, folks. That is what you call intense racing. It is for me, anyway. Hope you've enjoyed the video. Don't forget to hit that like, subscribe, the bell, and all the other bells and whistles that go here on YouTube. If you like it, give us a comment or a like. If you want to comment, drop us a comment. Till next time, as we say in the Black Country, ta-ra-da-bit!